Hello students, today we will discuss about the theory with the help of the diagram and tabular formation. We will study the law of diminishing marginal utility. In the previous class we have studied the meaning of utility, the total utility, marginal utility and the assumptions of the law of diminishing marginal utility. On that basis, on the assumptions of the law of diminishing marginal utility, today we will discuss about the theory with the help of the diagram. Before moving on to the diagram, first we will understand the theory of the law of diminishing marginal utility. The law of diminishing marginal utility states that as a consumer consumes more and more units of a specific commodity, utility which is derived from the successive units goes on diminishing. Here we can say that in making choices, most of the people spread their incomes over the different kinds of goods. People here prefer a variety of goods because consuming more and more of any one good reduces the marginal satisfaction derived from further consumption of the same good. And this law here expresses an important relationship between utility and the quantity consumed of a commodity. Let us understand this law with the help of an example. Suppose a man is very thirsty. He goes to the market and buys one glass of water. The first glass of water gives him immense pleasure, or we may say that the first glass of water has great utility for him. If he takes the second glass of water after that one, the utility will be less than that of the first one. If he drinks third glass of water, the utility declines again and again. And when the consumer consumes the fourth glass of water, again there may be a utility declines. It may be reaches to zero. In the slide, we may find that there is a table. In the table, it is an imaginary table where you find that units of a glass of water and the total utility column and the marginal utility column. In the table, we can say that when the consumer consumes the first glass of water, the total utility reaches to 20 and marginal utility becomes 20. When the consumer consumes the second glass of water, the total utility increases to 32, but the marginal utility becomes 12. And when he takes the third glass of water, the total utility increases to 40, but the marginal utility becomes 8. When he consumes fourth glass of water, the total utility further increases to 42. But the marginal utility here decreases to 2. And when he consumes a fifth glass of water, the total utility becomes 42. Here we observe that in the table that the marginal utility becomes 0, which means the consumer gets maximum satisfaction when he consumes the fifth glass of water. If he consumes sixth glass of water, the total utility also decreases to 39, which means the total utility becomes 39, and we find that in the column marginal utility column, the marginal utility becomes -3, which indicates that the marginal utility here changes into disutility, because when the consumer consumes the sixth glass of water in fourths, the utility changes into the negative utility or the disutility. The marginal utility, the law of diminishing marginal utility, can also be understood with the help of the diagram. In the slide, you may find the diagram where we have represented on the OX axis, we have a glass of water, and on the OY axis, we have marginal utility. MM is a marginal utility curve. This can be obtained with the help of the schedule which have given in the previous slide. when the consumer consumes the first glass of water, the initial utility is 20. And when he consumes the second glass of water, the marginal utility decreases to 12. And when he consumes fourth glass of water, the marginal utility further decreases. And when he consumes fifth glass of water, the marginal utility becomes zero, which means the consumer gets maximum satisfaction. Here, the total utility in the table, you find that the total utility becomes 42 and the marginal utility becomes zero. So we can say that when the consumer gets maximum satisfaction, which means the marginal utility is zero. Then also, if the consumer is consuming one more glass of water, that is sixth glass of water, then the marginal utility becomes the disutility, or in the diagram you find that the marginal utility curve, that is MM curve, is below the OX axis. This law is not applicable in certain cases. The law is not applicable to abnormal person like miser, drunkards, poets or philosophers, because the more money a miser acquires, more there is a desire to acquire. And in the case of the drunkards, as a drunkard drinks, more there is a desire to drink. Like that in the case of the poet or philosophers. Therefore, the law is not applicable to abnormal persons like miser or drunkards. It is applicable only to a normal human being. Second, it is said that the law is not applicable in a case of hobbies like a collection of rare stamps and old coins. The more the stamps you collected, you get more utility and more satisfaction. Therefore, it is not applicable for the rare collections. Third, the law is not applicable, that is, it is not applicable in the case of the commodities which are substitutes or complementary goods. If coffee is available at lower prices, the utility of tea would be decreases. Therefore, if the goods are substitutes and if the goods are complementary goods, then it depends upon the own supply of coffee and tea, or the substitute goods and the complementary goods. Next, the law assumes that other things remaining constant. That means if taste, fashion, income and habits of the consumer remains the same, the law will be holds good. But if there is any change in any one of the above factors, the law would be fail. The law will not be operate in the initial stage if the commodity is not in a suitable size. For example, if you offer a spoons of water to a thirsty man, then his marginal utility will increase initially, but eventually it must decline. With this, today we will wind up the class by studying all the exceptions to the law of diminishing marginal utility and the theory with the diagram we have studied, and we will continue in the next class or next session. Thank you.